Thank you for your interest in packet design. In this video, we will look at how the Packet Design Explorer SDN technologies can help service providers quickly provision new service paths. Today, many large businesses are geographically spread, and among their primary requirement is network connectivity between their branches, data centers, and global customers. This means that they often ask network providers for new transport paths. Sometimes they require path diversity to avoid failures, or perhaps they need low latency paths to specific locations. But provisioning a new path is time consuming. Providers must map their network topology, evaluate current network performance, and then use network planning tools to compute new paths that meet the constraints set by their customers. Add to this the configuration changes that must be carried out on all the devices along the new path, and it is easy to see why provisioning a new path can take many hours or even days. Let us look at how Packet Design's SDN path provisioning application can be used to define new services and quickly provision new transport paths, minimizing the time taken as well as the risk associated with manual path provisioning. Here, we have a simple topology on which we are going to provision a new constraint-based path. To start with, we can define new services by clicking on the service catalog found under the services menu here. The service catalog lists the services already created. To add a new service, click on Create New. Enter the name, description, and priority. Priority allows the provider to apply a new class of service priority and quota of bandwidth to the service being created. We then select the optimization algorithm, either shortest T metric, IGP metric, or lowest delay. Further constraints for the path can be defined from the More options here. Here, we can specify the tunnel type, either RSVPTE or segment routing, and enable protection by adding path diversity based on any of these options you see in the menu. This allows us to ensure that the paths created are diverse and thus have no single point of failure. The include or exclude options allows us to include or exclude nodes, interfaces, SRLGs, or affinity. For example, using the exclude option, we can define a path that avoids a specific geolocation by asking the Explorer SDN application to compute a path excluding the nodes from that location. After the service has been created, it is listed under the service catalog here. Then click on the service name to add subscribers to the service. Now, if you have not yet created any subscribers, you can do that by clicking on subscribers from the services menu. Enter the subscriber name, the ID and description and contract number, and click on Save to create a new subscriber. Now back under the service name, click on Add Subscriber. Select the subscriber you would like to add to the service and click on Add Selected. Now to provision a new path for the subscriber based on the constraints we defined earlier, click on New Path. Enter the source and destination PE routers. Enter the bandwidth to be allocated and enter the custom name for your path. You might have noticed that after the destination was entered, the Explorer SDN Path Provisioning app computed the best path based on the constraints we defined earlier and presented it. This page also shows the hops to be taken by the path that has been computed using SDN Path Provisioning application. We can then click on the Provision button to provision the new path. The Explorer SDN application works with a number of SDN controllers via APIs to help provision new paths in the network in a matter of minutes. So click on See All Paths, and we can see the path that has been created for the subscriber. Thank you for watching, and if you are interested to know more about our SDN applications and other products, visit packetdesign.com. Thank you.